Hey everyone, my Homelab NAS that I built a few months ago is designed for storage to help with my video editing. It has no graphics card, but it does contain a Ryzen 7600 CPU which comes with integrated graphics, which got me thinking, can I play PC games on this? Now to be clear, this is not an APU, it's not meant for gaming, so I was actually kind of surprised I could sort of play some games on this, including modern games like Rocket League. I also jumped into Nostalgia Land and I played OG Crysis, Witcher 2, Skyrim, and Final Fantasy X HD Remaster, which is my favourite game ever. It's the GOAT. It sends me. It's such a mood. Sorry, I'm working on my Gen Z slang. Let's just dive into the gaming results. So I tested each game at 4K, 1440p, 1080p, and 720p, and spoiler alert, 4K gaming on this Ryzen 7600 CPU is not really fun. So I booted up Skyrim, and it had all my old save files on the cloud from 2013, which was pretty cool. So I booted into one of them, and 4K looked pretty good, admittedly, but it was a slideshow with single-digit FPS. I'll show it on screen just so we can see it a bit easier. 6, 8 FPS, not very good. But a lot of the effects were turned up here, and I probably could have got double-digit FPS, maybe. The flames look pretty good there. Now I'm immaturely shooting a guard with an arrow, which you always have to do in a game like this, don't you? Sorry, Mr. Guard. What's that? You want an arrow to the knee? Happy to oblige. Oh, sorry. Uh-oh, bounty. Run away! Now it's now time to go over to 1440p. And if we look at that, I'm getting around 16 FPS, 15 FPS. Was that Cat? No, it wasn't Lydia. What? Don't know what that sound was. Anyway. The point is, yeah, 15 FPS, 16 FPS, it's not too bad, but again, not very playable, but considering it's on a CPU, that's not too bad. If we look outside, the FPS rates stay around the same, sometimes sit in 20. You can see RAM usage here is around 93% full, which actually means there's no RAM bottleneck here. The bottleneck is entirely with the integrated graphics part of the CPU being maxed out. As you can see, it's 100%. So now we go over to 1080p and it's actually half decent results now. It's getting over 30 FPS regularly when outside, and no, I don't know what Lydia's doing there. And that was a terrible shot, but let's try again. Sorry, you can tell it's a safe game, can't you, when I do stuff like this. I know it's harsh, but sometimes I just like to create carnage and then sit back and see what happens. Go on, Lydia. Don't worry, Lydia, I'll help. I'll shoot some arrows. I've got your back. Oh, wait. Ah, nope. Okay, time to go to 720p, and it's actually pretty good. It's often getting 50 to 60 FPS, as you can see, and things are a lot blurrier now because things are just, you know, this is a 4K monitor, ultimately. But the FPS rates are fairly good. You can see again the integrated graphics part of the CPU is just completely maxed out. If we go outside, yeah, things continue to be similar with fairly high FPS rates around 58, 60. So that's actually pretty cool, I think. And in terms of the results, it's unplayable at 4K, but then at 1440p, 1080p, and 720p, it's better. Which I think is pretty cool for, you know, integrated graphics. Yes, this is a fairly old game, but I think this is actually pretty good results. And now we come to The Witcher 2, which at 4K was absolutely terrible. I mean, the FPS rates were 1 or 2, sometimes even 0, so no frames being rendered. It was pretty unplayable. It averaged around 2, I would say, but I won't subject you to this anymore. So let's look at 1440p instead, and good-looking graphics. I did have a lot of effects on, but yeah, it was single-digit FPS rates a lot of the time. It wasn't exactly fun. So I went down to 1080p, and it was more playable. As you can see, you're getting almost 20 FPS at some times, although it was probably more like averaging 12, 13 FPS, I'd say, so not exactly great either. It was very juttery. But at 720p, it was actually a lot better. It was around 30 FPS a lot of the time, and yeah, it was playable. Not exactly the best graphics, considering it's downscaled to 4K, but not too bad. Killed everyone! Woohoo! Wait, who shot me? It's always the archer, isn't it? Come on, don't shoot me again. Avoid him, avoid him. And I'm just going to keep clicking my mouse to kill him. Come on, click, click, click. Yes, done. Woohoo! So in terms of the results, Witcher 2 did not perform as well as Skyrim. As you can see, it wasn't really playable at anything other than 720p on the Ryzen 7600 CPU. And now we come to Crysis, and it looks pretty good, as expected. Even though it's quite an old game, it looks really awesome. But the FPS rate is really slow. As you can see when I zoom in here, it's around 2 or 3 FPS. The RAM itself is fairly low usage, but it's just the integrated graphics part of the CPU that is maxed out. But this is a slideshow, so I'm going to move on to 1440p. This is me just out the sea. I absolutely love this part, and you can see FPS rates are around double digits, around 10 FPS. But it's still not great, really. At 1080p, things are a lot more playable. You're getting above 20 FPS rate a lot of the time. And the graphics still look pretty good, although there is some screen tearing here, which I wasn't sure why that was. I did play around with some of the settings, but I couldn't make it go away, to be honest. But overall, as you can see, FPS rates are above 20, which is sort of playable, and it looks fairly good. Then at 720p, the frame rates are really good, and I decided to kill everyone by hitting them for some reason. I don't know why. But yeah, you can see it's all fairly smooth. FPS rates are dipping down there because there's a lot of effects and a lot of things going on, but this is actually pretty good considering it's all on an integrated CPU. In terms of the results, you can see things aren't really playable at 4K or 1440p, then they are pretty playable actually at 1080p with 20 plus FPS rates, and then at 720p it's really playable actually. And it looked fairly good. There was not as much blurriness at 720p as there was with Skyrim. And then we come to Rocket League, but unfortunately it just wasn't loading. At first, what would happen is the loader would start appearing, and then sometimes it would go to full screen mode as though it was about to boot up the game, but then it would just crash and die. And I tracked this down to it just not liking the 4K resolution, but at 1440p things were a bit better, and the FPS rates were above 20 FPS, which is actually pretty good. Woo! And then at 1080p, FPS rates go up even more, and they often get in between 25 and 30, which I think is actually pretty good considering Rocket League is a fairly modern game. But yes, just about scored. 2 seconds left on the clock. 720p now, and FPS rates are often above 40. Hopefully I scored. Yes, that was actually a fairly decent hit. And yeah, 40 FPS, quite good. If we look at the Rocket League results now, you can see that 4K, it just didn't play. 1440p was sort of playable with 19 FPS rate average, but at 1080p and 720p it was very playable. I was actually really impressed with those results. And now we come to Final Fantasy HD, which was my favourite ever game. But unfortunately 4K, it just wasn't really playable at all. It was a complete slideshow, 2 or 3 FPS mainly. The RAM usage wasn't that high. This was just yet another case of the integrated graphics being exhausted for this CPU. At 1440p, we started off with a weird cropped mode for some reason, but ignoring that, the frame rates were at least in double digits, 11, 12, 13 FPS often, and it looked a lot smoother. At least it was playable, but it still wasn't great. Clearly, this isn't a great FPS result, and it did drop down below 10 sometimes. So at 1080p, things were a little bit better. At least they often were above 20 FPS. Dip into 15 to 16 at its lowest, which is a little bit disappointing. I thought it would actually hold up a little bit better than this. At 720p, things were a lot better, getting around 30 FPS. RAM usage is fairly low, and again, it's mainly just the integrated graphics part of the CPU that is completely maxed out. Every so often, frame rates would dip down a little bit, around 28 FPS, but in general, this averaged at 29 FPS, but often stayed around 29-30. If we look at the results, then things weren't really playable at all at 4K or 1440p, which surprised me, and even at 1080p, it wasn't very good results either. It was only really at 720p that you had half-decent FPS results. If we look at the results for all games, it's a bit hard to show on a chart, but really 4K wasn't playable with anything. At 1440p, it was at least playable a little bit with Skyrim and Rocket League. 1080p, then you had OG Crysis, which was playable as well, but then at 720p, everything was fairly playable. So kind of a mixed bag of results, but at least with some games, things were playable at 1080p and even 1440p, which surprised me a little bit. So there you have it. Yes, you can play games on a mid-range Zen 4 CPU, like the Ryzen 7600, but clearly it's not a good experience, and you won't be able to play really modern AAA games released in the last few years, or even decade. But this isn't meant to be a gaming chip. It's mainly to power the operating system's desktop, the GUI. The fact they can actually run some games at 1080p was a pleasant surprise to me. I tracked all of the FPS stats in FPS Monitor, which is a paid-for tool, but there's loads of free FPS trackers you can try, and I discuss them all in another video if you wanted to check that out, and that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.